I ended up having to pull my last video. It was a video that I entitled "I Found a Tramp's Camp in the Woods," and there's been a homeless man, actually two I think, homeless people have been living in these woods for the last year, 18 months. They're not here now. Their endeavours didn't work out for them. But one of these men I knew and hadn't seen him for a while. I thought, well, let's go and see if I can find his camp, make sure he's all right. That was my main prerogative. But I've since found out that he's safe somewhere else now, been rehomed, I think, or he's found a home. And I think the video caused quite a bit of controversy. I did have a pinned comment where if anyone had took the time to read that comment, they'd have understood where I was coming from. But I think very few people these days want to read. They want it all done for them. They want to watch a video and have it all explained for them. But I wasn't being critical of this guy. And the thing is, when you're broaching a topic of people living in the woods, then you're also, I'm out with my dog, so forgive the, come on, walk this side, you're also broaching the topic of homelessness and addiction and mental health. There's a whole lot of stuff which goes into the equation, and it's not really the remit of my channel, and it's not my personal strong point. I'm not a mental health provider, you know. It's beyond, it's something which is out of my depth in, I feel. So maybe I was a bit foolish really to put that video up. Anyway, although it is beyond my expertise, I do have an opinion. Everybody's got an opinion. We've all got opinions about everything. And you can listen to my opinion if you want. My opinion might be right, it might be wrong. It's subject to change over time as more information and knowledge comes my way. But I wasn't being... Well, I didn't mean to come across as condemning towards the homeless person living in these woods. I mean, I can't blame him for wanting to come to the woods for a bit of sanctuary, because, I mean, that's why I come here with my dogs, or that's why I go out camping. But these are lovely woods, probably about 60 or 70 acres in size, quite an expansive piece of fairly new woodland. I helped plant some of these trees a few years ago. We've got some nice sloes. Yeah, look at that look. Very tart, but lovely. Yeah, so I did find his camp. I did show it on the video that I pulled down, but I'm not going to show it now because thinking about it, I think it's not right to show it. But basically what was left was a huge mess. Potential biohazard, possibly needles. It was obvious that the person had mental health issues and addiction problems, I expect. And the tent is in a fairly hidden location, and I shall have to report it to the Woodland Trust and get them to clear it up properly, because it is a hazard, and any young children coming across the woods and coming upon that could go into that tent and and become harmed by potential needles or whatever which might be in there. But the young man, oh, here we go, the dogs are going to start pulling me. The young man in question, I met him on a number of occasions, and he was quite polite, and you know, I'd often stop and natter with him. But it was obvious that his endeavours were going to fail, because camping in an English woodland is probably fine during the late spring, summer and the autumn, but at other times of the year, dampness just accrues, and without the ability to actually heat your living space and air and dry your clothing and wash your bedding and air and dry that, it's just going to become miserable, because dampness will just accrue, and before you know it, everything will be damp, and it will be a horrible experience. You need heat, you need a wood stove or a fire, and that's something that he'd never be able to do here without being spotted. So that was one of the reasons why his endeavours were doomed to failure. Yeah, just we had a lot of rain in Britain, in England, and everything's turned to mud. But regarding this young man's situation, I don't know specifically. I don't know exactly what his circumstances were, but I can make a generalisation, and you can't blame people. When dog wants to go that way, I want to go this way. You can't blame people for how their lives turn out. It's a bit of a lottery, really, as to which family you're born into, as to how you're brought up. There's such a lot of handicaps put in the way of bringing up your family in a morally upright and beneficial way, because there's so many influences now coming in via social media, via the internet, via the TV. They call them programs, and I often wonder if they are indeed really that, programs to program people. And I think the soap operas especially were things like EastEnders. How that ever went aired, I'll never know. It just showing people a way of life which is so negative and is going to lead to hardships and family breakdown. So that's one influence which could have filtered down through this young man's life and made him homeless. The other is those early years. I'm always reminded of a quote by Aristotle. He says, "Give me a child until the age of seven, and I'll show you the man." Those first 7 years are so important as to set the path and trajectory of someone's life. And if those first 7 years aren't set up in a proper fashion, and that person's life could well be more difficult than it need be. You know, and the school system, again, it's set up wrong. These are only my opinions, I'm not an expert, just my opinions. You know, you go to school and they teach you all the highfalutin mathematics, simultaneous and quadratic equations and stuff like that, but they don't teach you the things that they give you the tools for life, how to invest your money, how to how to act responsibly. But they'll teach you stuff which will make you the robot, and that'll make you dependent upon the state. They don't teach you free thinking, they don't teach you critical thinking, how to analyse situations, how to maybe look at your situation now and the path that you're heading and where it might end in a year or two. Those things aren't taught. So people have failed in that respect as well. And in my musings, I was thinking, what? Who's to blame? Ultimately, it has to be, I guess, those people that have got their hands on the steering wheel and their feet on the pedals, the people that are guiding and running and governing this country. It does seem as though that's gone a bit wrong and all, doesn't it? So you know, maybe that's the reason why we've got homelessness on the rise, and we've got mental health issues and addiction issues on the rise, and hopelessness on the rise, because, you know, I've got my daughter and grandson living at home with us. She can't afford to even rent a home, let alone buy one. And that ability to sort of think, oh, I can knuckle down, get a job, get some money behind me, save up and get a house, is no longer an option for many people. You know, she's in a rollover. You daft dog. Come on. There's probably a horrible, nasty smell there, and she wants to roll in it. Come on, you silly thing. So I wasn't being judgmental on the guy. I kind of knew he was going to leave a mess, because people, again, aren't educated to be able to survive in the wild, to show respect for nature. It's not in their vocabulary to do that. And people that are on a level of addiction are living moment to moment, I think. I'm lucky that I've never had any addictions. I don't have an addictive personality. I don't have the need to smoke or to drink, and I can, but the only thing that I am possibly addicted to is caffeine, and that's a weak addiction. So sorry I had to take the video down. It is what it is. I feel that it's not right to show his camp, but I do believe he's safe, and I hope that he will be able to conquer whatever problems he has. That's it, really. So back, the channel goes back to normal again. I'll leave you with some nice images of the autumn, and then I'm hopefully be out camping again later this week. I got to fit a new tyre to one of my bikes, my hardtail mountain bike, which is what I'm going to be using more as the winter progresses, needs a new rear tyre. So I've ordered the new rear tyre. I'll be fitting that tomorrow, and then I'll be out on another camp. I got an interesting place to go on the next video, so I hope you'll stop by and see that. So thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next one.